Now, I'd like to tell you the story of Uncle Larry and his adventures in the great wide open.
Dude, I'd love to have a kayak and just go right next to the current. Thank you so much. What just happened, man?
What is going on these last couple days, man? Every day's getting cooler and better.
The sky was the limit.
That was amazing.
Right at the mouth of that river should have something. I feel like saltwater fishing is like freshwater, just it makes a lot more sense if you really get like tuned into it.
It's a little intimidating with such big water.
That's true. But I feel like because, oh, look at that. I thought I got a bite, dude.
Blue claw.
Yeah. Like it literally felt like a bite. I was like, wait, I got weeds. Well, we found life, dude. That's a great sign.
Now how do I do this without getting chomped? Oh, he wants this thing, dude. Look at this. I'm not getting my bait back.
That's crazy.
He's not letting go.
Hey, dude, that's Berkeley gulp. It's not even real. Come on.
You remember we were talking last night? I was like, yeah, I think the blue claws are more like aggressive.
Super aggressive. Like this came past him. Oh, he's
tickle his stomach.
Yeah?
Tickle his stomach.
All right. Now that we know that this area looks that good, they're fish, now we're going to have to get tuned in to the fact that, like, we need to get them to bite.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm thinking downsize to, like, one of those half-ounce jig heads just to get a little bit off the bottom, like, finesse these fish. They're majestic, dude. The way they fly.
I've been seeing more of those.
The thing is, like, that's what happens in the salt water. Brown trout are dope. I'm like, I love that kind of fishing, but what we've seen in the salt is just too much in the salt fishing. There's just too much to learn, too much to catch. Honestly, it becomes a lot more than even just catching the fish. It's like learning about just what's out here.
It's like warm by the
side.
Yeah.
Where it warms up a little bit.
Dude, I wonder if like that temperature line would be really good where it connects to the current from this little back bay. Yeah, wet wading too, dude. If you had waders on, you would not feel that at all.
I mean, like I said, you know a lot more about fluke than me, but we both know a lot about just fish.
But I have to assume like these warmer back bays where we're seeing bait.
It's gonna attract the fluke this time of year. Cause fluke like the warmer water, right?
Yeah,
pretty much.
Like fucking heat.
Yeah.
Come in the bay.
Oh, that almost felt like a bite. Oh, dude, look at that bait. It looks too good. Once you get the feeling that they're a fish, no matter if you get bit or not, it's always worth exploring again.
Probably striper back here, dude.
Oh yeah, 100%. And I feel like throwing the same bait, you can catch anything.
Dude, I feel like what I've been seeing with the saltwater too is the fluke might be a little different, but the midday bite, not the bite.
Yeah, either sunrise, sunset, or night fishing. Yep. But I mean, dude, the midday bite can be really good. That's why you just send it all the time.
Oh my gosh, dude.
And just seeing that how much life came out of night, I was like, that means that these bait fish must be kind of knocked
out. Oh yeah. Like you see things that you will not see during the day. Like right now we have full light. We can kind of see a lot more than at night. But because it's at night, because they feel a lot more protected, they just come out. And if you got headlamps, you can see what's out there. I liked it like before we were fishing close to the current, but not where it's concentrated like this right here. It's gonna be pumping through this like little channel. And this is definitely the main channel, no doubt about that. I do have so much faith in this spot.
So much faith.
Like, we kinda are gonna catch fish out of here. Like, dude, those bridges are well-known spots, but if you think about it, this is basically the same idea of a bridge, how like it just condenses and current pushes through, but it's just way more low-key. Dude, I'm really just finessing on the bottom right now. Super slow reel. Dude, let's cast around these pilings. I like the salt because it's kind of like river fishing or brown, so everything's always changing.
Constantly changing. This is going to look so different in 4 hours.
Green grass and high tides.
Yeah. Right.
Like, we are literally exemplifying that.
You want to get around in bulkheads and cast with the current?
Yeah. Oh! I got my heart pumping in now. It's just all these things that really feel like bites.
Dude, I don't know. No, dude, look at my bait. Was that a bite?
Ooh, very well could have been. Or a crab.
It was working like quick down current though.
Yeah, I want this water field.
Yeah. Got him. Fish on.
That was like a good one, dude.
Yo, dude. Is my GoPro on?
It's on, I think. Let me see again. It's on.
No, he's off.
No, I'm sorry. This is why we can't worry about it.
No, that's not. It was other than that, dude. Dude, what?
That looked big. That looked big, right? Is that a big fish?
That was a big, big fish. Dude.
There could have been anything.
I think that was a fluke, but dude, the way they flap, right?
They go like.
Yeah.
And then they do crazy head shakes, like. They'll pump like. Were you feeling like four or five consecutive pumps flatten out and it would pump again?
Yeah.
I think you had a big fluke.
Dude, you see how it's a lot deeper right here? Bro.
And it's warmer.
We really just found something. I really felt like it's so much deeper out there, dude. It's a lot.
There's more.
Oh, dude. That really, really got my heart pumping. Dude, I wanted to land that so bad.
I wanted to see what that was so badly.
Dude, I lose too many fish.
That might have been a freaking doormat, dude. Imagine the doormat from the shore.
The thing is, like, you could see by the way it was fighting, that was not a small fish. Oh boy. So I think now that I know what that bite felt like, the one back there was a bite. Nailed. Absolutely smoked, dude. Like, wait.
Alright, if you're getting smoked like that, that's probably.
Dude, he bit it off.
That's a fluke. That's a fluke. Grab
it. Yo, another gulp. Dude, they're just missing it. Johnny, I've never been this hyped before in my life. Oh my god.
Did I tell you the cigarette? Strategy?
No.
With fluke?
No. Yep.
You're saying if you get like a big hit from a flounder, he was talking about flounder down south, but same thing applies.
Yep.
He's like, almost imagine that like you have a cigarette in your ear.
Uh-huh.
This guy was a hick.
Cigarette in your ear?
Like, imagine you have a cigarette in your ear, you get the hit.
Yeah.
You pull the cigarette out, you put it in your mouth, you light it, take a puff, set the hook.
Really?
And like, that's too long. I think
no, it's like frog fishing. But, you gotta like wait a second.
You gotta know that like he has it. You saw the Skinner thing. They're like,
I was gonna say that,
at
yeah.
The bottom, and then they'll kind of.
They start like
they,
inhaling
like, they,
it.
They take the bottom half and then they inhale it.
Okay.
See, the more we fish, you're gonna feel that when they inhale it.
Dude, this is pretty much my first time actually fluke fishing. So like, it's gonna be a learning experience.
That was so sick. Oh!
Got
big
him.
One! Big one?
Yeah, dude, this might be a bass. I don't even know, dude. Bass, bluefish. Off, he's off. Dude, this hook is really bad.
You wanna get another one?
Wait, what was that, dude? That might have been a bass. That one felt like a bass.
Dude, is that hook bad? It's a spro, right?
I mean, dude.
Is it an old spro, though? Let me feel
The hook looks sharp, but the barb is really bad.
The barb is totally dulled.
Well, dude, this is getting so many bites, though.
No. All right, freaking whack.
All right, dude.
That didn't look like a fluke, that one.
No, I saw it was like whitish. It looked like a blue or a
striper.
For that bite, I worked it pretty fast. I wonder if some of these are blues.
I'll take anything out of this spot, just like being sport a new spot.
Let's get one.
Do you think this guy has any idea of the fishing in his house?
No. Yeah, this guy has no idea that there are giant fish right in his backyard. Like, he's probably, dude, his boat looks like it's out or something. Like, it's not here. He's probably out there fishing.
Or he's not even out here.
It's time for the next bite. I kind of feel like Skinner right now, dude. I like the way he sets the hook. He just pops it, you know?
Dude, he is so disgusting.
We kind of feel disgusting right now, too, dude. What we're doing right now? This is crazy. I feel like this rod's like a little bit too heavy, especially for the fluke.
Mm-hmm. Where are they hitting you?
Do you see where the current line is?
Yep.
Right there. Because, dude, I shouldn't have lost three fish in a row. Oh, dude, that was another bite. What? Do you want to buy that one? Dude,
it's probably like $2 million.
Dude, I'm so hooked on saltwater.
So am I now.
This supports chapter one in my saltwater fishing book. This is my chapter one, dude.
This is your chapter one. That is sick.
Chapter one, send it.
For fun.
Yeah, it'd be amazing. I feel like it would let us get a lot off our chest. Like, it's hard to say in one sitting in like a video. Oh, you're throwing the diamond jig? All right, dude, please just get us a blue because if they're out there. you will get them. Or a striper.
You can catch anything.
That's true. That's a good point.
You can catch fluke.
Dude, you're right. It's a feeding window. They're not biting right now. It's not because they're not here. But now this is a tail end of incoming. It's like just fish every tide.
Just gotta keep fishing. Some just blew up right there.
Where? For real?
Yeah. Well, it's not good.
Dude, you're about to get nailed.
Oh yeah, dude. Let's go. What's it feeling like?
I think it's a small blue. Or a striper. It could be a striper.
Dude, finally. All right.
Dude, it keeps feeling like he's coming off.
It's still on there. Giving you a good fight.
Here, watch out. Watch him on.
Yeah.
I think it's a striper.
Yeah, I think so too, for some reason.
Where's the blue?
That's a blue.
Blue?
By the way, he just ripped drag. Yeah.
Blue.
Nice, dude. Dude, that's not a bad one. Did that largemouth bass jump? Yo, Johnny, give me some, man. Landed the first one of the day. First of many.
Pulling him up into the grass like this.
Look at this spot we're fishing right now. Catching blues, losing fluke, most likely. There's stripers out here.
Just holding the rock with it.
Dude, this was the exact goal. Just come out here, explore it, find what's out here. Whatever it is. Oh yeah. Watch out for the teeth though, man. Like, you want the pliers?
First landed fish of the day.
Hold them up, dude. Yes.
Yes, dude. It's not a bad little blue, honestly.
Not bad at all.
Ready for the release?
Yeah, underwater.
Dude.
That was so sick.
He nailed that diamond jig.
For real.
Dude, the way he was like fighting though, I thought he was something else.
It kind of felt, it looked like a striper at first.
I thought it was a striper.
Dude, we're getting so fucking dialed. It's so intense.
We are, dude. Yeah, I really, at this point, I don't know what to say. How far out did he hit?
He hit me, like, kind of where you start to see the ripple line.
Yeah.
Like, kind of, not like close to us, but not far either.
Dude, I'd love to have a kayak and just go right next to the current. Because, like, I feel like if we could just drift around out there, we'd get a lot of bites.
Mm-hmm.
I would love to land one. I'm just hyped to see you land on that. But dude, it's such a team effort when we come out here.
Oh, we're just getting so dialed together, it's so crazy.
The thing is, we come out here with like just an open mind to what we're gonna find. And that just makes it so much more epic when we land a fish. Because we're not even like, our heart's not set on catching a fish or not. It's just growing as anglers and figuring out what's out here.
Well, it's such a cool feeling to like almost like, okay, we can almost now go anywhere in the world
and just catch some fish. Yeah.
Whatever's there.
Because all we're doing is just throwing things that are just going to catch fish and figuring out where the fish are going to be residing. And we both knew this little channel right here is going to be loaded. Yeah. Like,
not like ripping this in either. I'm kind of just
gonna... Yeah. I feel like the slower the better for saltwater. I mean, not too slow, of course, but. Not ripping.
Dude, like, these bait fish can't fight the current really. So it's like you almost want to like imitate that.
Totally, yeah. Not something unnatural that they're just going to always have reactions right to. Something that they're going to be key onto. I feel like
maybe you rip it when like they're just feeding.
Totally, yeah. I think that's the difference between like brown trout fishing and this. Like a lot of times for brown trout, you want to get that reaction strike because like you know that they're right there. But here, we're trying to find the fish. So in that sense, we want to work a little bit slower. And just get those spicy, like they're actually trying to feed on it, not just getting pissed off and seeing and chasing it.
Dude, like here's what we could do for a video, like for real.
Yeah.
Like, you could literally just,
yeah, dude. Another one. Am I feeling bigger?
Yeah. Definitely bigger. I think it's probably another blue.
Or a striper. Who
or
knows?
A striper, dude. For...
Could be anything. Oh, blue.
Yeah.
You just kind of know that first big run. But hey, dude, we're catching fish, and like that's all we dude, wanted to do out here.
I mean,
that's
bites like this.
Big fish.
This is way bigger.
Oh.
He's oh. going out.
You see his tail out there?
That? What? Big one.
This is a yeah. It's a big fish. It's a blue for sure.
It's definitely a blue. Dude, it's a big
dude.
Blue,
looks like a shark. He's putting his fin out of the water like that.
He's a shark. Like, I not. Oh my god, it's giant.
Giant.
I think it's really good.
Like, we were catching him off the jetty, not like even on the GoPro. Yeah, I think it's running. It's running?
Yeah, it's running.
We know it's running,
dude.
This
one feels heavy, man.
heavyweight champion of the ocean. Or the bay, actually.
This one I might need to like land up in the grass.
I agree. Dude, this is like kind of crazy. That first, I got the bites on this fluke jig.
It's a good giant one.
Oh my god!
Giant one.
Dude! It's got a big gash inside. Oh no!
Oh my god, it was huge!
Dude, what?
It was huge!
He did a largemouth bass jump. Eric would have loved that, dude. See, Eric needs to fish the salt. Like, that was like a largemouth bass on steroids.
That was like a 28, 29 inch blue.
Yeah.
That was a giant.
That was
blue.
The same size or bigger than the ones we were catching on the jetty. And that was off camera, dude. Usually when you put the GoPro on, the fish don't bite. They're biting.
Yo, that was a giant. I wish I landed him now.
Well, dude, he's on film completely out of the water at your feet. Like, dude, that's going to be the thumbnail of the video. You like this with a blue jumping. Dude, yo.
Dude, for the video, we could put up, like, all the footage we have of us camping that we have.
Yeah, yeah.
All the pictures. Just, like, let's just make a shitty video.
But cool an epic stuff. Video. Yeah.
Right. Oh, my God, my wrist hurts. Right when I thought I really want to land him, he got off.
I think that this video might be, like, the coolest video of them all. Like, just most fun to watch. Because, like, I just kind of threw the GoPro on. I didn't do anything. I just walking around, talking about what we're doing, figuring out stuff as we go. Dude, this entire week, like, all the sounds we're doing, we're feeling into the bites. And we're like, wait, like, this is going to happen. It happens. The blues are back in town. The blues are back in town. But, hey, so are the fluke. All right, dude, busting out the SP. Time to catch some blues. Uh-oh, dude, I have a leader on here. You know what that means. I need redemption on a blue. The thing is, we moved around to find this spot, and there's no hesitation in my mind to keep moving.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, I feel like with saltwater, like...
keep exploring.
Totally.
Yeah, that mentality to stay still is retarded.
Yeah, just sit in one spot and wait, let
That's
the tide
so
change. Yeah, no. Dude, I realized, though, something about the reason why I like the salt so much. These bluefish are like trout mixed with muskie and every cool freshwater fish, but they're in the salt water. And like, you can only find them here.
And they fight so much harder.
Dude, they look sick. They fight hard. You have to be dialed to find them. There's nothing wrong about bluefish.
I'm kind of a fan of bluefish.
Dude, I wonder, back in there, maybe by another one of those docks, dude. Like that dock out there, maybe.
That's
could...
what I was thinking, if we like get out to that point.
Yeah, yeah. We just saw a fish pop here in the shallows. There's a lot of shrimp moving around. I'm gonna rig up this gulp shrimp on a smaller jig head. I've been wanting to like finesse some fish up. Dude, look at that. Look at that.
That's a Florida special right there.
Oh my gosh. Gotta seal up the gulp real good.
That looks good.
Sweet.
Got the Haskell's custom clips.
Yeah, shout out Haskell's, dude.
Shout out Haskell's for the clips.
That's one
he did Uncle Aries.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, it cast pretty well too. All right. Dude, the fish popped right here. I'm thinking instant bite. What are you throwing?
Still throwing the diamond jigs. It's fucking working. But yeah, all wrapped up here. What if I just have a fucking fish on there and it popped off the bottom?
Oh, it looks so good. I feel like I'm largemouth bass fishing.
Yeah, that could be the fluke bait. Oh,
look at that boat.
Want to take it out?
Pump it up. You have to look at it, right?
And dude, the second you think you found a spot and you keep moving, you just find another spot. Like now, we didn't necessarily think there were a lot of fish back here, but they're popping off on top. Like, dude, do we know saltwater fishing like the back of our hand?
I guess we could.
Like, you think you need to know so much, but it's just about getting out there.
We whacked five good bites so far.
Yeah. Like, I'm just glad that you landed the fish, because the thing is, it's a team effort. Another fish rose right there.
Yeah, it's been pretty good.
Yeah.
Some pretty big bluefish. Lost, I think, a fluke. Oh, we're just throwing back.
Yeah, catch and release.
Pretty much catch and release. If you want, okay, we'll bring it back. Absolutely.
Oh, thank you.
No, of course.
Yeah,
no,
we
definitely
don't want
not.
Money. Just been waiting the whole shoreline. I live in West Hampton. I wish I knew. We just landed one 20 minutes ago right there. So.
I think they have it?
I actually don't know what the size of it is. You know what? We'll look it up when we catch one. If it's big enough, we'll bring it to you. No problem.
That's what I'm saying. Fishing just works out, dude. I'm telling you. I've seen it happen too many times to not just appreciate it. Wow. Dude, so quick little recap, what just happened. We met Greta, who is gonna let us take a canoe out. We're gonna catch her bluefish. Dude, just getting out on the scent, like, what even is happening right now?
That was the nicest thing anyone's, like, ever done on the scent for us, I think. Like,
yeah, by far.
Talked for 5 minutes, and then she's like, you can take my
beautiful old town canoe. This is the kind of positivity that the scent brings us to, man. Like,
we have to catch that blue now.
We're catching.
Not leave until we
get dude, did you see this nag darter swimming?
No, I didn't.
Ridiculous.
Can you just like drift it through
here
real quick?
Okay. Perfect. Thank you so much.
And have wooden paddles, but I think these will be better.
I think those are perfect.
Yeah. Awesome.
Okay. Well,
thank you so much.
You know, that's the front, you know, the back.
Sorry?
That's the front.
Oh, that's okay. Front, yeah.
Yeah, because it has to be, the front person has to have their legs,
feet.
You know, you have to
yeah.
And the other thing is, you know, the back person has to steer.
Exactly, yeah.
The front person just paddles.
We couldn't have asked for anything cooler today. Like, thank you so much.
We will be back shortly with the fish.
Yep. This is bringing me back to the canoe fishing days. I used to have, I mean, obviously not a canoe as nice as this, but what just happened, man? Dude, I really feel like now we're like Tom Sawyer and Huck Finn. This is kind of what they did. Dude, people are just like that when you put yourself down in that position to foster those relationships. Yeah. Drift all of this. Dude, no wonder why we're getting bites in here. Yo, I gotta move the rods real quick, 1 second, because I can't paddle right. Dude, like, yeah, I don't know where exactly to... Just watch behind you, the rods are kind of behind you. Yeah. Here, slow down. Alright, yeah, I've cleared space on the GoPro, so now we're chilling. Look at this mag darter. I guess you'll see it when it comes in. Alright. Oh, wait. What the? How did that happen? Am I under you?
Now I don't think you're anything. And you're under me.
Got him.
Already?
First cast.
Oh, dude, we have to. Let's go right to Greta.
Let's just keep him in the boat, dude.
Huh?
We'll just keep him in the boat. Oh, giant.
Got him?
Oh, he has no chill.
Here.
Can you tail grab him? Oh, he's gonna jump. Dude, watch for the hook. Watch for the hook.
Yeah.
Like, really, really, really watch the hook.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, dude.
It's a big one.
All right. Ready. Oh, watch out. Oh my God.
Oh,
this is dangerous. This is actually dangerous. Oh. Watch out for the jumps. Oh my God. All right. Wait. Just don't tip the canoe.
Dude.
There we go. All right, dude. My first blue of the day. Let's go, dude. First cast in the nag darter. First drift up in the canoe. Again, thank you so much to Greta for letting us take this canoe out. And just sharing the passion of the outdoors with us. Like, this is crazy. Dude, what are the chances we meet someone who gives us a canoe when we're out here just on the scent? We need to buy a canoe.
But first cast with a new bait. That was amazing.
Oh my gosh. Dude. What
this
is life?
What is going on these last couple days, man? Every day's getting cooler and better.
Oh my
God. Life is amazing right now.
I was gonna go home today. I don't think I can.
No, dude, you gotta stay here and fish again, I guess.
Yeah, we're just fishing. Well, dude, look.
Oh, dude.
Like, it's like a darter, dude. It's a mag darter.
It's like a popper that swims 6 inches below.
Johnny, who thought we'd be portaging a canoe? When we just started out, not even know if they're fish here. Dude, this is a send and a half, man. This is why we get out on the send. Like, the thing is, you can only say so much on Instagram and on your story and tell people, but like, just seeing what actually happens when we get out here.
This is like,
it's a crazy sport.
It's kind of like, this is like a book.
Yo, another thing we're fishing right now, incoming tide.
Wait, striped bass is the largemouth, like a red tail is to an osprey.
That's a good point. I'd like to do more research on it.
Although, you know what, dude? Scientists just make that shit up. like the world just evolves.
Yeah.
And like,
and we send it.
Yo,
Nux again for this shit.
This is the coolest day. Dude, what the fuck?
This is the coolest.
This is the coolest day yet. And the day before was cooler than the day before.
But dude, this series.
The day before.
Johnny, this is the coolest video of all time. I've been filming all of it.
Yo, dude, there's a couple other senders out here now.
Because they're all fishing outgoing tide when it switched over, I guess. Is that just what people do?
I think they might have got off work.
Dude, the energy of the send, like just the power to get out here. Like what, dude?
I can't believe that.
Got him? Let's go. Nice, dude.
It's a good eating one, dude. Small one.
Dude, we're gonna bring like 6 blues. Let's freaking go, Johnny.
We both caught it one, dude. It's so special.
And who knows, it could be a stripe or anything. Blue. Yep.
I think it's probably a blue.
That's a nice blue. Dude, I kind of want to double up right now. Let me know if you need a hand.
I think I got him. I got the leader.
Oh, watch your rod. Oh.
Wow, I thought he was done. I'm Greta's canoe.
Dude, I've never saltwater fished from a canoe, ever. I was like, dude, remember when we were wet waiting like 10 minutes ago?
Yeah, dude.
Remember we were just like sending it and then this happened? They're perfect eating size too. Like at one point we were just fishing just the bank, which is sick. Like I love doing that. But now we are on the water.
On a canoe.
In a big way. I've never fished in a canoe in the salt. Or in any small boat. Another bite. Wow, dude. Yo, bro.
What a day.